My parents were just really quiet, and I was just waking up from the surgery, and all I remember is being wheeled across the parking lot into the hospital to be admitted. And there the doctors told me that they had found a 9-centimeter tumor. They didn't know if it was cancer yet, so they took a piece of it to test it and stuff. And they just basically told me they're pretty sure it's cancer and that I would have to go through chemo. It was called rhabdomyosarcoma, and it was stage 4, which through other tests they found on a regular CAT scan, your body looks white except for like your brain and the places that are working. And you compare my body picture to that, and mine looked like a black Christmas tree. The cancer was everywhere throughout my body. And for me, I was just in shock. And I later found out that with chemo, I had a 20% chance survival rate. And without chemo, I would have maybe 6 months to live.
I feel like you got run over by a truck, literally. We came home and I set both boys down and said that Katie's really sick. She's in for a long fight. It's gonna take a hard fight, but if anybody can do it, it's her.
When we asked one of our doctors, how many have you had survive this? And they said, kind of shook their head and said, we've only had a handful make it to 2 to 5 years relapse, and it almost always relapsed. But we held on to the hope that, okay, every child is different, every story is different, and so ours is going to be different. Within just 2 weeks, she started losing her hair, and that was hard. And I remember we went over to my sister's house, and some of the guys shaved their heads first, and then shaved hers. And that's when it became real.
That was the moment, it's real.
When you lose your hair, you know you have cancer. The type of cancer that Katie had required very aggressive, harsh treatment, right after the other. It was, I think, 96 treatments over the 17-month period that she did chemo and radiation. And she spent her 16th birthday there. She spent Christmas, Thanksgiving, Easter, 4th of July, probably too many holidays to count.
It's emotionally, physically, financially draining. It's just hard all the way around.
The doctors and the nurses, they really were our family because we were there so much, most likely 3 days out of every single week, it felt like, sometimes 5, we were at the clinic, and there's not enough words to even describe how we feel about the people there and how we are forever connected with them.
We couldn't have done it without PCH.
She knew that we wanted her to continue chemo. We wanted her to try to keep fighting, but she also knew that her body couldn't do any more of that. It was already broken down so much, she couldn't do any more. Dr. Graziano did her chest tube surgery, and at that time she pulled us aside in another room and came to tell us that there was so much disease in her lungs that we only had a few weeks left with her. And go and do things you want to do. Go to the movies, do whatever you want to do for these next few weeks, and make memories. The night, September 17th, of 2013, we knew that that was really the time. And we, the five of us, her brothers and Steve and I, were on the bed with her, and we said our goodbyes and I love yous, and she told her brothers each something, and it was just a really special time. And she went to sleep, and later she woke up in heaven.
From the moment I was diagnosed, my parents prayed that whatever his will be done, whether he wants me to go home to heaven with him or stay on this earth to share his story. And immediately after we prayed that, there's a verse that talks about the peace that passes all understanding. And we felt that immediately.